Hi, I'm back with an update on the latest changes in Home Assistant. This time I'll show you everything that's new in the May 2025.5 release of Home Assistant. There have been updates to the backup system, entities can now be selected more easily, voice variations have been added, you can now paste automations and scripts, and much more. Let's dive right in! Every month it's exciting to see what new and fun things are added to Home Assistant, and this month is no exception. The May release 2025.4 will be available starting Wednesday, May 7th, so from that moment on you'll be able to start using these new features yourself. New options have been added to the backup system. First, you can now set the retention time per location, either based on the number of backups or the number of days. There's also a new option to automatically create a backup before updating your operating system. Some people like to have a backup before running an update, while others don't. That's why there's now an option to set the default state of the backup toggle in the update screen. Additionally, Home Assistant now waits to restart until any ongoing backup process has finished. If you have Home Assistant Cloud subscription, you already have access to many text-to-speech voices. Now even more have been added. Not just new languages, but especially new intonations. There are now voices that sound happy, angry, sad, and more. This allows you to make the voice match the context of your automations.
Yay, it's your birthday! Don't you ever do this again! Please subscribe to my channel!
Not all languages are supported yet, but it's a great addition nonetheless. In the previous release, device and area info was added to entity info dialogs, so you always know what you're looking at. Now you can also see in which area and to which device an entity belongs in cards, automations, and scripts. This means you no longer necessarily have to rename entities. Still, I recommend giving your entities clear names, especially if you ever need to replace a device. It helps keep your existing automations and dashboards working without any extra effort. Note, the entity ID is no longer shown by default in the interface, but you can still enable it in your profile settings if you prefer to see it. There have also been changes to Z-Wave. I don't have any Z-Wave devices myself, so I can't demonstrate them, but here's what's new. Z-Wave long-range devices can now also be added directly, and Z-Wave Smart Start is now better supported, letting you easily add a device to Home Assistant by scanning its QR code. This is a big one. You can now paste YAML code directly into the UI for automations and scripts. This makes it super easy to share automations with others. Just copy the YAML code and paste it into a new automation in the UI. Personally, I think this is the best improvement in this release. It's now also possible to use templates in automations and scripts while keeping the UI available. In the past, using templates meant you could only edit in YAML mode, but now the UI remains usable. Very convenient! This This one's more for power users. Under Settings System Network, you can now see which devices Home Assistant automatically discovers in your network. I probably won't use this much myself, but let me know in the comments if you find it useful. Of course, there are also new integrations again and improvements to existing ones. You can find them in this list. Besides everything I've shown, there are other interesting changes too. These are also listed here. As always, there are backward incompatible changes. Be sure to read through these carefully before updating to avoid issues in your smart home setup after the update. That's it for today. What a release this was. Let me know in the comments what your favorite new feature or change is. I'm really curious. Thanks for watching, and a special thank you to everyone who supports me monthly. You make it possible for this channel to keep going. You can also help by becoming a sponsor. The video description includes links to Patreon, Ko-fi, and how to become a paid channel member. Don't forget to give this video a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel, and click the notification bell. See you soon. Bye bye.